All right. Good morning, everyone. Today, I have a few things I need to do before I have to get to my regular job. But I have to go check some vending machines real quick. I have to go pick up some stuff for my business. And I don't know, probably some other stuff. So let's go. I don't know if y'all remember or not from the Disney video, but I finally got my Halloween Stitch and then Mickey. I don't think I told you about the Mickey, but I got the Stitch. And also since then, 100 subscribers. So awesome. Amazing. We love to see it. We're going to see 1,000 next, right? Because you're going to subscribe. Because 47% of you aren't subscribed. But 53% of y'all are amazing and awesome. The other 47%. Shame, shame, shame. But the other 53, y'all are awesome and amazing. And I thank y'all so much for subscribing to the channel. And I said I was going to do a giveaway. I've been teasing it in the comments. So I'm going to be giving away a penny to a lucky person who subscribes and shares. No, I'm just kidding. Giveaway, I am thinking one of two things. And I think I'll give whoever wins it a choice. So you can get a plush from the Shop Disney website. Probably not Halloween, because you'll probably want a Christmas one if you want that, because it's gonna be Christmas time by then. Because this video is being published on like the 19th of October, I think. So I'll give you the choice of a plush under $25, please. We have a budget here, people. We have a budget. So $25 or whatever the lowest, whatever the Christmas one is, because you know Disney raises their prices all the time. But either that or $25 gift card to Chick-fil-A, God's Chicken House is what I like to call it. So yeah, I think the winner will get to decide between that and that. And all you have to do is, like, I'm not a huge channel yet. We're gonna get there to 1 million subscribers one day, but I'm gonna keep it very simple. Like, obviously. Subscribe, obviously. Share, and then comment which one you'd like. And if no one comments, then I guess I won't have to give a prize away. So yay me. But like I said again, thanks for watching and everything. I'll be checking to make sure you share. Thanks for watching and subscribing. 100 subscribers is absolutely amazing. 101 now, I think we're at. But definitely amazing and awesome. And I cannot wait to see what the future shows. So to win either a Shop Disney plush or a $25 gift card to God's Chicken Coop, like, subscribe, comment, and share. All right, and back to the video where we will be doing vending machines and other things and other cool stuff and a lot of vending machines, a lot of money, and a lot of blah, 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 blah. Side note, if I seem super tired, I am, because it is 8 a.m. in the morning, and actually 8:49 a.m. in the morning, and I have been up since, I think 10, if not 9 of yesterday. Oh shoot, that's almost 24 hours. Oh god. All right, yeah, I gotta go.
And now back to your regularly scheduled program.
We got everything we need. We got a label maker in case we gotta change prices, candy for our bulkhead machines, extra fruit snacks, my sunglasses, got the money, yeah, money bag, and my little portfolio. So let's go. Some gas, I'm just waiting on that real quick. Yeah, I got the fit on, got the, you know, like the fancy polo shirt on and jeans, stuff like that. So I'm ready to go service my machines and do other things. So yeah, just filling time, waiting for gas. Yeah.
5 minutes later.
Yeah, Tesla. That way I can just, you know, plug it in. It's ready to go when I wake up in the morning. There we go. But no, I need gas. So we have to wait. Still waiting. Well, I mean, if you have the supercharger, you'd have to wait too. But like, my thing is, you just go home, you plug it in, and then you never need a supercharger unless you go on like vacation or something. So yeah. All right. Well, waiting on gas.
Let's check it. rolling in them palace, but you're too tame. I ain't for the south, but I appreciate the wood grain. Never calling me about the noise, it's only two, man. I'm in the same building, but the flows of view change. I ain't for the
weight. All right, I don't know if y'all saw that last clip or not, but I just checked the machine, pulled a good bit of money out for 2 weeks. I think it would have made more if I had chips in there. When I stocked last time, it was kind of like halfway on the chips, I think. I'm going to go look back at the video and see how much inventory I had in there last time. But that's why I take the video too, because I get to see the inventory. But I'm probably going to go get chips and stuff right now and stop at Sam's Club, since I'm closer to Sam's Club than I am to like my house right now. So I'll probably go do that because I got a little bit of time to burn as well. I'll probably grab something to eat while I'm over there. And yeah, come stock this machine with chips. They're worried about the pricing on the chips, which I sold out of the chips, so I'm not worried about the pricing. The chips are, I think, they go to between like 75 cents and a dollar a bag. I think that's fair. Because I can't get the bigger bags right now. They're all like sold out. So once I get those, I'd like to put those in there and raise the price even more. But I think I might, for this location, just keep the smaller bags and keep the prices where they're at. There's some stuff they're not eating, like some of the healthier stuff, I guess. Like the cereal bars aren't really going. They're eating a decent amount, I guess, of like the bite-sized stuff that I put in there. That stuff doesn't really cost me much, so I don't mind if I even sell it, honestly, because I sell like, me selling one pays for like five of them, basically, so that's fine. So yeah, I'm gonna go to Sam's Club, grab some chips, the cashews, I think, and stuff we're selling out. Candy bars were doing great. They're doing okay. There's something selling like a couple. But yeah. Like I say, made a decent amount, so I'm happy. And I put the coins back in the thing. What I like to do with the coins, if you saw that on the video, is I don't like to take home really like the dimes and nickels, because I really just like the quarters. So I'll fill up the change, the coin dispenser change, whatever you want to call it. And it takes quarters, dimes, and nickels. So I'll fill it all the way as far up as I can with the dimes and nickels. And then the quarters are usually filled up pretty high too. But yeah, the quarters are, everything's topped off right now. But yeah. And then I just threw the rest in my bag. So I did take home some nickels and dimes, I think, because the coin, what is the name for it? Dang. The changer, the coin changer. The coin changer is full. So yeah, let's go to Sam's Club. Here's what I got. We got the two things of chips. These are for both locations of chips. Cookies for both locations. They're on sale now on Smart till next year. And then with the honey buns and the cookies. Like I said, those cookies were new. These ones right here. And what kind of business owner would I be if I didn't sample the product that I'm giving to my customers to make sure, you know, it just meets our highest quality standards. We just have some high quality standards. And I just, you know, want to make sure this product upholds those. That is definitely the reason why I'm eating these. Not because, you know, I haven't had anything to eat today and I'm absolutely starving. Because no. I should have got the dollar hot dog in there. But we're just testing the taste quality for our amazing customers. And this is one small ass bag. Interesting. Okay. Let's see. That's a pretty small bag. I mean, face size, I don't know. Glasses size comparison. That's not horrible. It's like a 75 cent bag. What I bought them for. I also make double profit on that. Mm-hmm. Okay. Tastes like a Pillsbury cookie. Alright. I decided to get myself some real ones. Because I do have a pretty long day ahead of me still. So I went to Chick-fil-A, got some napkins, and then some fries, and a sandwich. I don't want to make a mess, so I'm just eating it. Just believe me, I got it. Just believe me. And I have my little tray table set up, too, down here, if you can see that. I don't know. It's like this little thing. It was only like 15 bucks on Amazon, something like that. But it connects to like the bottom of your steering wheel. It just like snaps on. And then it's a little tray table. And then you put your napkins out on it, and you get your sandwich and your fries out the bag, you throw it on the tray, you pop a YouTube video on in a minute, or some Hulu or something, take a little 15-20 minute lunch break, and then we'll get back to making our money, and I drop my sauce on the ground. Yeah, then we'll get back to making that money I got. I got to refill that machine. This looks like the Sorry, I'm trying to make a lot of noise in this bag. I just looked at the inventory for it last time I was in Chick-fil-A line. And, let's see, last time, cashews were pretty stocked, stuff like that. The peanuts actually, I think I forgot to buy them. But they come, it's like 12 peanuts, 6 cashews, 6 honey roasted or whatever. The honey roasted and the cashews selling, the problem is the peanuts aren't selling. The peanuts are like 12, it's 12 and 6. So I think I'm going to wait till those peanuts sell before I buy any more, or else I'm going to be stuck with a bunch of peanuts, and I don't want to be stuck with a bunch of peanuts. Mm-hmm. And I got cookies and stuff. I'm probably going to change some prices real quick on some of that stuff. This machine's hard to change the prices on. The other one's really easy to change prices on. So I'll take a look at that. So good. It's so good. Chick-fil-A on it today, people. And I didn't buy any candy because candy's really, really expensive. And they've like barely eaten it. Probably like not even the next trip. Like the next service, but maybe the service after that, then I'll maybe need to refill candy. So we're talking like 2 to 4 weeks from now, something like that. Unless they just start going for like crazy. My candy prices on that one aren't even that bad. It's like $1.25. Candy cost me like 88 cents. And then the other machine has like $1.50. So yeah, I'll just see what I'm gonna do about that. I'm not too concerned about that, because I mean, the candy's like, candy's expensive. There's, the margins are pretty low on that. I thought it would do some higher sales. The chips I have higher margins on. I'm eliminating. Chips, high margins. Cookies, high margins. Any of those little bags of stuff, super high margins on. So I think that's where I'm making most of my money right now. That, and the chips seem to make a bunch. Chips completely sold out. Honey buns sold a little bit. I bought honey buns for the other location as well, because I know they're going to sell, because that was like a big thing that they wanted me to buy. So yeah, I'll surface that other location tomorrow morning on my way to campus, since it's near campus. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and enjoy my food real quick, and y'all go get y'all a snack, enjoy some food, and we'll be back in a moment.
All done stocking top shelf. Second shelf. Touch this shell. That's heavy. Bite size shell. And the bottom shelf is 3 mac and cheese
and 3 gorditas.
There we go.
That was almost scary for a minute. They were turning off all the lights. I thought I was by myself in there for a minute, but I wasn't, because there was still like 3 or 4 people there. But yeah, did that. I made an extra $2.25 while I was gone. So now I'm gonna go pull this bulk candy machine, refill that, and then head home and get ready for my job. So let's go.
Future CZ here. I didn't have time to count that the day of, but here it is now. So total made $44.40, so cash $35. Coins 940. So yeah, haven't made our profit back yet, but we will get there eventually. So 44.40 was a collection for that day.